Which tripod is the best one for you? I'll go over some options on today's episode of
Ask David Bergman.
Hey everybody, welcome back. Here I am, as always, answering your photography questions. Don't forget to go to Ask David Bergman right there on the site. There's a form that you'll see. If you have a photography question, you can fill that out. I'll get those questions and pick the best ones to answer right here on a future show. Also, if you're not already a subscriber to the Adorama YouTube channel, go ahead and click that button down below. Use the little bell icon so you get notifications. You'll be the first to know as soon as new videos come out from myself and the other hosts right here on Adorama TV all week long. Also, I host a series of workshops that used to be live in person. Right now, I'm doing them online as often as I can. And hopefully, eventually, again, we'll be back out live doing my concert photography workshops. You can get more information about that at shootfromthepit.com. Hopefully, I'll see you on there soon. All right, let's get right to today's show. I got a question from Greg Y, and he wants to know, can you recommend a portable tripod that is good quality but won't break the bank? Tripods, boy, that's one of those things that maybe you got one already as part of a bundle that came with your first good camera. It's made of plastic and barely holds the camera that it came with, right? Now that's a good start, but there are definitely better options out there at all different price levels. But first, why would you buy yourself a tripod? Well, tripods are one of those things that you might not know that you want until you really need one. Now me, I'm primarily a still photographer, so that's gonna be my point of reference here, but it kind of goes without saying that a lot of video is actually shot on a tripod. So videographers, they're gonna have different requirements when it comes to things like size and stability of their sticks. That's what the cool video kids call their tripods, they call it sticks. But anyway, for us still photographers, having a way to solidly support your camera without touching it is great. When you're doing things like shooting landscapes, for example, you might be out there for a long period of time, hours and hours, right? Just waiting for the perfect light. And it would be super tiring to have to hold and reposition your camera every time you want to go ahead and take a shot. It's not going to be in the exact same position. You also might shoot things like long exposures in low light, or maybe you do astrophotography, or you like to bracket your shots or do time lapses, or even things like self-portraits, right? Most of those things are going to be challenging to do without a tripod. Now, besides keeping your camera propped up, a good tripod is also going to help you to actually make sharper images. It really kind of surprised me a little bit, somebody who's been in this business a long time, but I was shooting a calendar in Central America quite a few years ago, and I was using really high-powered strobes and was overpowering the sun. I figured that the fast flash duration was all I needed to freeze the action, and that usually had worked really well for me. But these images were going to be printed very big, and I was using a very high megapixel camera setup, so I needed to make sure that even the eyelashes were tack sharp on the models. Now, when hand-holding the camera, I actually found that they weren't as sharp as I expected. And I wasn't sure what it was at first, but I switched to a tripod, and then the difference was night and day. Everything was super tack sharp. Now, I still prefer to shoot handheld, so I can be a bit more mobile in a situation like that, but it just proved to me what a solid tripod can do. So if you're having trouble getting tack sharp portraits, a tripod might actually be one piece of the puzzle that can help you there. Okay, so now that you've decided you actually want one, which one should you get? Which tripod should you get? There are those $25 plastic things, and there are also tripods that cost thousands of dollars. Now, I think most of us are going to fall somewhere in the middle of that range, so that's where I'm going to focus this video today. No doubt that you absolutely get what you pay for, but anyone who needs a tripod that costs over $1,000 probably already knows exactly what they're looking for, and they're not tuning into this video to find out. Now, the tripods I'm going to show are all made by the brand Manfrotto. There are, of course, other brands out there, but I have quite a bit of other grip gear from Manfrotto, and I think that their tripods are the best balance of price and quality that I've seen. I've had my existing Manfrotto, I think it's the 344B, for over 20 years, literally over two decades, and have traveled around the world with it. It has taken a serious beating, and the material is still in really good shape. Some of the threads are actually starting to strip, and I could probably have it repaired or pick up replacement parts if I wanted to do it myself. I'm actually still using it to hold this camera right here, but I decided that it was time for me to get some new ones. So in the last few months, I've done a lot of the research and picked up actually three new tripods for myself. Now, keep in mind, there are many options out there, but these are the ones that I actually use. So I'm just talking from my own experience. Exactly which tripod you get is going to depend on a number of factors, and you really have to determine your own needs. The most important things in my mind are the size, how much it weighs, and how much weight the tripod can actually hold. There are other factors like what kind of leg locks and whether you need a center column or not, but I think that those are actually secondary to size, weight, and capacity. So the first tripod I have is actually the Compact Action Tripod. This thing right here costs about $75. And last time I checked, Adorama had it on sale for $69.88 or something like that. So it's a relatively inexpensive tripod. This thing is gonna be a good step up from the cheap plastic ones that we talked about before. The pros are that it's super lightweight, right? It's only 2.5 pounds. This thing weighs basically nothing. And it folds up really small and fits in this enclosed carrying case, this included carrying case, right? It just fits right in there. So when this thing folds up, super small, no problem at all. It's really well made for the price because it's Manfrotto, so you know it's gonna be good quality, and has a super easy permanent ball head on here with this sort of unique pistol grip, right? And the way this works is you can loosen or tighten using this little wheel here, and you just tighten it where you want it and it's gonna stay, right? Now the thing is, it uses this little proprietary Manfrotto quick release button here, right? And I'd actually buy one or two extras of these just in case, because it's only gonna be a matter of time before you lose this thing. And if you do lose it, you are out of luck. So I would get a couple of these. Basically, this attaches, you take off the little plastic cover, this attaches onto the bottom of your camera, and then it just simply goes on there, you latch it down, and that's not gonna go anywhere. That's just the plastic. I guarantee you I'm gonna lose this plastic piece in a very short amount of time. The downsides of a tripod this size and this $75 are not completely unexpected, right? Because if you're paying less than $100 for a tripod, there are gonna be some trade-offs. It really simply can't hold that much weight, right? It's gonna top out at about 3.3 pounds. So this is really made for an entry-level crop sensor camera with a kit lens, right? It's gonna be perfect for like my Canon M50, and you can use a point and shoot or a GoPro or even your phone, right, with the right attachment on there. But I would not put a DSLR on this thing at all. That ball head won't hold in place unless you're perfectly level, and the center of gravity is gonna be so high, especially if you have the legs extended all the way, that it really can fall over very easily. With almost any tripod, I actually like to hang my camera bag from it, right? You find a spot where you can just hang it on, and that's gonna stabilize it a bit more because it's gonna add more weight to it in the field. So if you can work within those limitations, this would be a great tripod to travel with, or just for shooting something indoors like a portrait or even a vlog if you do those. Now, if you're ready to step up to something sturdier that can hold a lot more weight and gives you the most flexibility when positioning your camera, you are obviously going to spend more money. That's just goes without saying. I'll just say that tripods, they are a solid investment, right? A good one will last literally decades like mine did. And it seems crazy to spend thousands of dollars on a camera and a lens and then just have that set up barely balanced on a wobbly tripod, right? That just doesn't make any sense. So at the other end of the spectrum from that Compact Action Tripod is this. This is from the Manfrotto 055 series. And really the biggest decision you have to make here is what material you want for this thing. Manfrotto offers most of their tripods, most tripod companies offer most of their tripods in either aluminum, which was sort of the standard material, the industry standard for a long time, or a carbon fiber, which is the latest and greatest, right? Carbon fiber is lighter, it's stronger, and has better shock absorption properties. But of course, that also means it's gonna be more expensive. Now for me, this tripod is gonna be primarily in my studio, so weight really isn't that much of an issue. In some cases, especially for outdoor use, like in the wind, people feel that a heavier aluminum tripod might offer a bit more stability. But for me, I figure if this thing ever does leave the studio, I can always hang my camera bag from it, like I said before. So I actually chose to go with the carbon fiber version, and I've got the MHX Pro ball head right on the top here. This setup is gonna handle just about anything you throw at it. It's rated to hold nearly 20 pounds of gear, and these super thick legs means that it's really stable. Now, some people don't like center columns. Basically, as you expand this, in my small space here. As you expand this center column, this thing can come up, right? I do agree that center columns, when they're raised up, it's gonna make any setup a little less stable. I do try to keep it down all the way when I'm shooting, but it's nice to know that it's there in case I need a little more height. Also, the center column on this one actually goes horizontal. I'm not gonna demonstrate it right now, but trust me on that, you can raise it up and flip it horizontal. So that's gonna be good for shooting super low angle because the legs on this thing, you can spread them out almost flat to the ground. And then when you're shooting horizontal, that camera is gonna be really low to the ground. So it's gonna give you a lot more options than that small lightweight tripod is gonna give you as far as positioning. Now this carbon fiber version weighs 4.4 pounds and costs about $550 without a head. The aluminum version weighs about a pound more, which doesn't seem like much, but you carry this thing around all day long and you're absolutely gonna notice it. If you can deal with the extra weight, the aluminum version is otherwise exactly the same. It holds the same amount of weight and is only $300. So at almost half the price of the carbon fiber, you get pretty much the same thing for just an extra pound of weight. Now, in either case, you're gonna need to add on a ball head. I like the MHX Pro that I have on here. It's about $170, or you can get a $200 version that has a bigger Pro plate. This is the Pro plate on there that I like because it's a little bit bigger. So this setup here is about $750 total for the carbon fiber, and it's gonna be a long time before you need to buy another tripod after using this thing. But be aware, this thing is not small, right? I wouldn't travel with this unless you make good money doing the kind of work that requires a heavy duty tripod. I do think there's one more option between the $75 lightweight and the $750 Big Mama that might be the best of both worlds. It is this. This is part of Manfrotto's Be Free line, and it's the GTX Pro travel tripod. The legs are a bit thinner than the 055 line, but somehow it's actually rated to hold more weight at just over 22 pounds. But here is why it's really awesome. It folds up super small, right? You actually close it by flipping the legs up over the top. Let me show you this. When it's open, you open it up like this, and that's the center column there. And this thing, when it goes down like so, now you have your tripod, right? So the legs are super adjustable. You can put it wherever you want. So that is basically a full-size tripod. But then when you fold it up, you just bring that center column back up, right? So it's up there like so. You bring the legs up like this, super easy, and voila. You've got a really small tripod setup. Now, once you've done that, it's really about the same length as the $75 tripod. It's a bit thicker, but it's gonna hold 6 to 7 times the weight, and it fits in this nice little case that it comes with. The carbon fiber version of this is 3.8 pounds, and Adorama sells it with the ball head for about $430. If you don't mind adding about 3/4 of a pound, you can get the aluminum version for $290 all in, right? It's definitely made for travel. So I would lean towards carbon fiber if you can afford it, because whether you're hiking with this or just watching every pound for your carry-on bag at the airport, you really can't go wrong with this. Now, one side note, something photographers have very serious arguments about is the type of locks on the legs. You can find tripods that come with twist locks like this, or flip locks like this, right? Where they just flip open like this. Anyone who uses a tripod often will probably have a strong preference towards one or the other. They both work absolutely fine, but personally, I prefer the flip locks. I just find that opening and closing them all at once is much easier and quicker than having to individually turn all of the twist locks. I did go with the twist locks for this Be Free because it's primarily gonna be my travel tripod. And I just figured that the twist locks don't stick out as much and it's a bit more streamlined for packing or strapping to the side of a backpack. But in general, I'm a flip lock guy. Your mileage may vary. So there you have it. Gary, you asked about a good quality tripod that won't break the bank. Manfrotto is excellent quality and is exclusively what I use. If you want something inexpensive and are only gonna put a very lightweight camera on it, get that compact action tripod. For a big tripod that's gonna hold heavy cameras and isn't gonna travel much, look at the 055 line. And finally, my recommendation for the best of both worlds is the Be Free line, since it's small and light, but it's also gonna hold plenty of weight. So you certainly have options. Now, if you're confused about those options, I'm gonna put a link below to the Manfrotto tripods page on Adorama. You can go ahead and use the filters on the left side to pick the material you want and other things like how much weight you need it to hold, how high it goes, how small it folds up, and anything else like that. That should allow you to find the perfect tripod just for you and your situation. I hope that helps out. I know it can be confusing. There's a lot of different decisions to make, but you just figure out what works for you and you'll be good to go. Remember, go to AskDavidBergman.com, ask your own photo questions right there. If you like this video, please hit the like button. You can comment below about it. I'll be in the comments as much as I can. And I'm back here with a new episode every week right here on Adorama TV, Monday at 10 a.m. This comes out. So I hope I see you next week right here on Ask David Bergman. Thanks so much. I'll see you soon.